I guess say welcome to the Gamers Dice Duo podcast number 31. I am one of your hosts, TB Staff, you can call me Teddy, and over there is Eric along with his little co-host. I forgot his name.
Eli
the cat, just hanging out. He's gonna be joining us today.
He's hanging out.
He's
right
a
here.
Special guest. Yep. Eli, what do you think of Rise of the Tomb Raider?
Oh well.
Gosh dang
it. It looks cool.
He was like leaning towards the mic. Dude, he's looking at the mic. It's in him. I know. He's got the inner podcasting soul. Oh, look, he's grabbing the mic. He's dropping the mic, some might say. Gosh dang it. We're an entertainment podcast that mostly talks about PlayStation, video games, Destiny, superhero, comic book stuff, TV, movies. And speaking of movies, Eric over here, otherwise known as Legend PVM on the Twitterverse.
I've seen Ant-Man.
You knew exactly where I was freaking going with that. Yeah. Oh my gosh, that is adorable. But you need to freaking go see that. I don't care if you're going to be a third wheel with Gabby and Jared. Just be like, I don't care if you go by yourself. Just look. Oh, dude, I went people. Oh, by the way, we've been completely off schedule. Like, we had one after E3, and then we had 2 weeks of none, and then we had one jam-packed with stuff. This is just one after last week. This is a legitimate regular episode, so I feel like we're back in the groove. It's nice. Yeah. But yeah, last week, or last Monday, the day after the podcast, I went to the theater with some friends from work to the theater to see Ant-Man, and that movie was freaking awesome. But the point is that I got there before them, so I went up to get my tickets, and it was in the middle of the day on a Monday. So I went, and I was like getting my tickets to, and it wasn't a giant theater, but it was like a medium sized. It wasn't super small, but it was nice. So I walk in, and I was like, one ticket for Ant-Man, and the guy was like talking, being nice, and I was like, and this was before my friends had gotten there, so I was like, I could consider just coming here by myself. Just come in to see a movie, just hanging out, you know? So I'm honestly considering going to see Ant-Man again by myself because it was so good. We're not going to talk about Ant-Man spoilery this week because Eric hasn't seen it, but my official review, 10 Elis out of 10 Elis.
Woo!
best movie in it. But for real, it was really good. Legitimate review would be like 8.5 out of 10. Gosh dang
it.
Best lyrics in it. Yeah, it was really good. So go see Ant-Man. So what have we been playing in the past week? Oh. I just realized Eric has...
I've added to my arsenal.
He has added to his arsenal. He definitely has.
Or the trio is complete, actually.
Oh my gosh. What about that quadrilogy? What about that Wii U, son? Oh, it's so sad.
Will that ever happen? No.
It's so sad. I want to play the next Zelda. And that's legitimately it. You know what I mean? But I don't want to buy a Wii U for that. Oh my goodness. He's
literally
there.
Like standing on my leg, and it's like chilling on my desk.
Just hanging out.
Yeah. But yeah, got good old Xbox One over here.
Not the original Xbox for you kids who are confused.
Actually, now that I think about it, I have an Xbox, the original Xbox, in the other room in a Walmart bag, because my sister took it to her friend's house.
I was about to say, I was like, why do you have...
My sister took it to her friend's house to play Coder on it. So, and then I have Xbox 360 up here, and then now got the whole family.
The boys are back in town, as some would say, as we said last night playing Crucible.
Yeah, I finished the trio, got the PC... Got the PS4.
He has the Master Chief Collection, and that's pretty much it. But that's all we really care about. Until
and I
Halo
got
5.
This amazing headset.
No, not at all. But especially since freaking Xbox, you know, one big thing about the Xbox One, doesn't support standard 3.5 millimeter headsets, doesn't support USB headsets. Very freaking weird. I don't get it. But if you buy this $25 adapter here, you can use it. But you know, they're actually fixing that now. They're
really?
We should just have this cat cam the whole time.
Yep.
I am perfectly okay with this. But yeah, they're not like fixing it. Like, it's not going to be possible on your current controller, but the controllers that are shipping with the Xbox One in the future have it. Still no USB.
I'll just buy another one of
mic support. That would really help me when it comes to streaming, but
I'm sure I'll be able to use that controller then. Right.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you could. What do you mean? What can you use until then?
I mean, like, if I get that controller, will I be able to use my headset?
Yeah, but that's way more expensive a solution than this $25 adapter. Oh, he's gone. He's out of here.
Where are you going, mate? Where are you going? Where are you going, mate?
You're here for the internet's entertainment. You're leaving.
You're here.
Oh, my goodness. That's sad. The cat's held hostage here.
I mean, he's looking at himself.
He's like, oh my gosh, is this what I look like? Am I really that adorable? I was going to say ugly. I was like, nah, it's a pretty cute cat. Eric, you know how it has taken me like a month to play through the first Halo and I'm on the last mission now?
Right.
Eric just, you know, went through it in like about 2 days.
A day?
Yeah.
Two days.
So GG. But we're gonna play. Oh my goodness, we're gonna play Halo 2. It's gonna be great, dude.
Yeah,
I legitimately am gonna. My goal is to catch up by Halo 5, and
dude,
I think it's possible.
Here's the funniest thing: when I was playing Halo last night, and I was just, you know, just trucking along. Sneeze. But I was just trucking along, and then I was like, "Wait a second, I can actually play Halo 5."
Yeah,
I totally forgot that this allows me to play Halo 5.
That's the whole deal. I'm excited for that. Freaking Sea of Thieves! I'm telling you, that game looks dope. You can have a mutiny, dude. You can like freaking mutiny against your captain and make him walk the plank.
Dude.
And they're like real people. Like imagine
basically DayZ.
DayZ, but pirate DayZ. Heck yes. Oh, yeah. So, you've been playing that. We've also been playing a crap ton of Destiny. We've been getting back into that. We've been helping Jared. Wait, did this happen last week?
Yeah.
It's only been a week?
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe it was 2 weeks ago. I don't know. But if you didn't know, our friends Jared and Gabby, who we play PC games with forever, got PS4s in Destiny. We've been I think we finally wore them down over a year of talking about it. 24/7. But Jared is really enjoying it. I feel like Gabby's enjoying it too, surprisingly. Just
I think she is, but she's kind of like wants to get through this like little slow area in the game.
I don't know. She was playing earlier today by herself doing bounties.
Yeah,
so that says something. Yeah. I'm excited for them. I'm so freaking excited to do their first Vault of
Glass. I think
next
time we get on, we do Vault of Glass.
I do not think so, because Gabby is not leveled. Jared is not leveled enough. Jared's close.
He's 27.
He's 27 now?
Yeah.
If he's 27,
like, he
I'm
has
down
a light for it, he just needs to upgrade his armor.
Yeah, I'm down for 27, but I want to do it with Jared and Gabby as their first time. That'd be awesome. Because Gabby will never do it if we don't do it with Jared. So, but yeah, you've been playing Destiny.
True, but
what else have we?
I've actually done two sets of bounties today.
Dang, like, son. I was at work.
I've maxed out Noah and Beyond, and I almost maxed out Bad Juju.
I only have like 5 more guns to max out, which is awesome. Because it used to be way, way more. One day, I'm off Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday this week, and it's freaking awesome. One of these days, I'm just going to sit down with Destiny and go ham. Like, do freaking 3 sets of bounties, do just everything. But
right.
It is not this day. Lord of the Rings. Anyway.
Hard light. I need to get hard light up.
Yeah. The ones I need are, I'm going to see if I can name off the top of my head and if they're correct. No Land Beyond, Invective, Universal Remote. Dang, I couldn't get there. I couldn't do it. Oh, I still need Mida. Yeah, I do still need Fourth Horseman, and I think that's it. Yeah. But also, Eric, I want to go, just letting you know, I was thinking about this today. I want to go ham on Skolas.
Yeah.
Like, I want to do it 3 times a week. Like, every freaking week. Because, like, imagine it's this. Like, yeah, imagine we were playing in Vanilla Destiny or whatever, and we didn't. Like, you know, every exotic is, like, a chance. Like, everyone. Like, freaking Galahorn and Hawkmoon, they're all like, oh, you run the Nightfall, you could. Run the Raid, you could. These are guaranteed. If you run this one activity enough, you are guaranteed to get it. It might take a while, but you're getting... And I'm like, frick, why have I not been doing this? So, yeah, we need to freaking get on that crap. And one night we need to do Crota Hard with Andrew and Taysom one night this week.
Oh, yeah.
Heck yeah. I'm really
It's funny because at level 27, you can actually run Crota's End.
Yeah, you can load into it,
But technically, you could carry someone and get the armor, and then they would be, like, really... They would be, like, 30 or something?
Yeah.
Maybe not 30.
I think it's funny, like, people were originally trying to do that, and then it's like... I mean, you can carry them if you do a really good job, but also, they'll just keep dying. So, like, unless they go sit in the corner...
I mean, they're useless. Yeah, they're useless.
Exactly. They're useless, but it's not just that they're useless. They also add a difficulty as to reviving and continuing with that if you're doing normal mode. And I don't know. That's not cool, you know? That's not... that they're not part of the experience.
Yeah.
It's a bummer. But we've been playing Destiny. Last night, we played Destiny. We played the Crucible with me, Eric, Jared, Andrew, Ryan, and Taysom. So we had a full 6
That was good.
Fire. That was amazing. That's why I'm so really liking Destiny again. It's reminded me of all those awesome moments that happened. We didn't lose one game. We played, like, I don't know, 8.
We, like, just stayed in the group and just
that
kids.
That one match on Exodus Blue was dope. We just ran in a circle around the map as, like, a pack of 6 people. Oh, it was great. So, I don't know if I've been playing anything else other than that. If I have, I don't remember. Played a little bit of Skyforge. I don't know if that was before or after last time we talked on
really?
The podcast.
Really? You played...
Well, no, I'm saying when me and you played.
Yeah, we talked
that...
about that.
Okay. But I jumped on and, like, looked around and been like, man, I kind of want to play this. And then I logged off. I did that. Oh, yeah, but Ryan has been out of town, so we weren't able to play Minecraft, but tonight, after this podcast, we're freaking playing Minecraft. It's going to be so awesome,
Jared.
And Jared bought Minecraft on PS4.
Not Gabby.
Gabby, she didn't buy it, but we should tell her to.
Actually, I should probably tell you this. Me and Jared were on Minecraft last night.
And I saw that message, and I was...
I was going to send
you a message that was like, you guys better not have done a lot in our world. We literally waited for Ryan for a week and a half.
We actually didn't do that much.
Okay, good.
We built some buildings.
Yeah, one that was very phallic, apparently.
That was Jared. It didn't even mean to do that.
But yeah, I put in Swaglords. That's our Facebook chat.
Swaglords.
Yeah, Swaglords. What? That's so dope. But it's like it's been there for so long. It's just like...
It just...
It's a thing.
What else
now.
Are you going to put there? Seriously.
It's a thing now, you know? Like, I would never change that. But I put in there earlier today that I think when we get on, our goal should be the XP farm.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, does anybody, what do you guys think? And Andrew and Ryan were like, yeah, I'm down with this. So we're going to, when we get on, we're going to freaking watch all those YouTube videos. We're going to get up a super legit skeleton XP farm, and it's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's basically what we've been playing for the week.
Right.
On to the news.
Actually, dude, I didn't tell you. I haven't for like past like week or two. I've been just playing some Dishonored. It's so good.
Yeah.
I can't wait for Dishonored too.
I've been reading a lot of comics because I'm trying to freaking get through this one comic book that's really big, but it's taking forever because it's freaking giant. And I sat down one day and I was like, I'm going to just sit here because I have a day off. I'm just going to sit here and I'm going to get through all these comic books. And I sat down and I read for like about 2 hours and blew through one of them and got like halfway through the big one. And then I just like, you know, as I was reading, I started like falling asleep. Because reading does that. If you're sitting there reading for too long, at least for me, I start to like drift off and I'm like, crap.
I think the worst thing is when you're reading and then like you don't have your bookmark when you wake up.
Oh, you like fell asleep while you were reading and then you're like, crap, where was I?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a bummer. I've had that happen before. But yeah, freaking, I did a lot of that this past week. But yeah. So, on to the news.
Yeah, the news.
I'll talk about one thing that I think is really freaking awesome, and then you should pick out something from here. I want to talk about the fact that they didn't make a big deal of this, but Dishonored, the Definitive Edition, you know how they announced it at E3 and then didn't really say anything, but like they didn't give a release date or price or anything, but it's coming out on August 25th. So a month away, and if you owned it on PS3, it's only $20.
Yeah,
and if you are a long time, like PlayStation person, at some point, I think it was like some point, probably like 6-8 months ago, Dishonored was free on PlayStation Plus for PS3. So if you had PlayStation Plus in the past year and now are playing on your PS4.
It's are you going to get on PS4 then?
Yeah.
You might as well.
Yeah, I might as well. I will have now bought Dishonored on 3 different platforms. But I don't even care. I don't even care. Because trophies. Trophies. The PS4. Yeah. I got to do it. I was like, it's like I wanted to start it on PC, but then they announced Definitive Edition. And I was like, crap. Now I got to wait.
And then they say, you can get it for $20.
Yeah, and then I'm like, all right. Okay, I guess I got to do that. But yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah, that'd be worth it, dude. It's one of my favorite games. There's like literally nothing wrong with it besides it's a Bethesda game. There are some like weird glitches that aren't really game breaking.
I love that that's a Bethesda thing. Like why really I don't know, but it is.
Like there's weird graphical glitches with Bethesda games, so
Alright, but yeah, I'm gonna be playing that when that comes out in exactly a month. So, speaking of what's coming out, I just wanna remind you, Eric. Do you know what's happening on Wednesday?
What?
Windows 10 is dropping for all of our computers.
Yep.
It's just gonna happen.
It's gonna be like there.
4 days. Like,
I haven't like seen anything about it.
See, I saw a little bit, and I was like,
not even like screenshots, right?
Yeah, I saw a video, and I watched like 30 seconds of it, and then I was like, to be honest, I kind of just want it to hit, and then just be surprised, you know, and just start getting used to it.
That's kind
of and why I don't know, but that's kind of what I want. So I'm freaking excited. Got freaking Cortana. Got Xbox One streaming, mouse and keyboard. Some specific Xbox One games.
I hope it's not for Call of Duty, though, because then GG.
All those kids are going to get wrecked by the PC players.
Yeah.
So, just a reminder. Reserve your copy on Windows 7 and 8.1.
Mm-hmm.
Moving on. What do you want to talk about, Eric? I was waiting for, like, you to transition.
Let's talk about this Battlefront news here.
You know what's weird is that this isn't really that much of news. They just kind of confirmed it. Like, this was a thing at E3, you know?
I'm not sure what this is, honestly. What's going on here? Inform me.
EA Access. I really should make sure you read the doc before we start.
Yeah, but I mean, hey, it gets the conversation going.
Well, yeah, but I feel like I'm the only one that knows about a lot of this stuff, other than Destiny stuff. Freaking, we're both all on that Destiny crap every week. Gosh dang it. So do you know what EA Access is?
Yeah, I've heard
of it. Yeah, EA Access is part of Xbox One and not, I believe it's not part of PS4. So, but it's going to be EA Access, you know, it lets people play the game like a week early. And if you're part of EA Access on Xbox One, Battlefront is gonna be on EA Access. So you'll, like, if you're on Xbox One and you have an EA Access subscription, you'll be able to play the game a week before everybody else. Which is, like, I don't really care, you know what I mean? I think it'll be cool that we'll be seeing, like, gameplay and stuff of the game on YouTube and whatnot and on Twitch mm-hmm. before the game launches. But, like, I have an Xbox One now. I don't think I'm gonna care or do that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it... Trophies, man. But, really, it's just because, like, I'm gonna have my character and my profile on PS4, so I'm not gonna, like, right. play for, like, a week and there and then switch over, but...
Jared is gonna get it on PS4, so...
Yeah, boy. I'm totally getting it on... I mean, I legitimately was... I
feel like I'm gonna get on PC eventually.
I might just pre-order it pretty soon, to be honest. Somebody at work was like, one of the guys at work who's a gamer was talking to me, and he was telling me like all the different games he has pre-ordered. And I was telling him that I was very tentative on pre-orders this year because of AC Unity, but I forgot. One of the reasons why I freaking pre-ordered games was so that I didn't have to worry about money. Like, the stress relief was gone. Like, I don't know. I'm going to college this fall. I don't freaking know if I'm going to have money for Battlefront and Fallout and all that. Like, I might not just have $60 to drop that week. You know what I mean? So I might just get on that for a very few select, like, Battlefront, Fallout.
That's probably what I'm going to do with my next paycheck.
Yeah.
Probably just Battlefront.
My next paycheck, I'm probably going to do Halo 5 and Battlefront.
Halo 5.
Yeah, I'm doing games. See, that's the thing. I got to pre-order Halo 5 just to, like, get it done. And see, that's the thing with my Xbox, too. Like, once last paycheck, I got a 12-month Xbox Gold. And then this next one, I'm going to get Halo 5. So it'll be, like, I'm pretty much ready and don't have to worry about buying things on there until Halo 5 comes out. Because I already have freaking, you know, Sunset Overdrive and a bunch of the Xbox games. But... once that's done, it's done. So I'm gonna do Halo 5 and then don't have to worry about my Xbox until Sea of Thieves comes out.
Right.
And then probably get to work on
I just used my like 14-day trial, so
yeah,
that actually gives me the exact enough time until I get a paycheck.
Yep, so. That's what I did too. I was like it's gonna run out tomorrow. But but once you know you got your year.
I was your year, yeah.
Yeah, you don't worry about it for a year. Oh man. So, Eric, we've been talking about news, but yeah. So if you're interested in Battlefront, if you're an Xbox One player and you really are gonna get Battlefront on
if your home is on Xbox,
and you're gonna get Battlefront on Xbox One, freaking buy EA Access for a month and. Have it there for that 1 month.
Or don't, because you don't want to support EA, but you still support them by buying the game anyway, so it's a lose-lose. Wow, shots fired.
EA is so much better than they used to be, dude. Everyone freaking trashes on EA. EA's doing really well recently.
I don't like the guy who speaks at E3, though.
I love that guy. He's awesome.
He looks like a snake.
He's one of the...
Freaking slithery snake.
He was like the CEO of Xbox, dude, for like the Xbox 360 generation. He had to deal with the Red Ring of Death. He was on an episode of Podcast Unlocked. It was awesome. But yeah, that guy's really cool. He was talking to... Kind of funny. He's a cool dude. He may look a little weird, like you're saying.
He looks like a sneaky snake.
But he really is not. He's a really genuine, awesome guy. You should go watch some of
I don't even know what his name is.
I did, but I forgot it. Because I have a horrible memory for everything. But Eric, we've been talking about news. Let's watch something. Unless... Have you seen Mockingjay Part 1?
Yeah. Here's the funny thing. No.
Wow, you suck. Gosh, dang it. We're not watching that then. Anyways, people.
But I've already seen that trailer, so.
Oh, okay. Well, there's a Mockingjay Part 2 trailer.
Whoa. Noises. Out.
Well, what was it? Was it like an ad started playing or something? Yeah. It's like, whoa. I had that happen earlier. I was just like listening to music and I
it was like ad randomly. But it was a GameSpot thing.
It's funny when you're like listening to music or watching or usually listening to music and you can like hear little voices and you're like, what the frick, where's yeah, that coming yeah. from?
I think the worst thing is when you have a bunch of YouTube tabs open and it's like, okay, restart your computer, and then you after it updates and restarts your computer, it pulls up all the YouTube tabs and reloads them, and so you just hear voices everywhere.
And you're like, ah, close.
Close.
Yeah. But, where were we? What the crap rabbit hole did we just go down?
Mockingjay.
I just wanted to address for people who are, you know, normal and have seen Mockingjay Part 1. That's a whole nother thing. But the trailer looks freaking awesome. Just like all the other movies. I'll say it quick. This is my deal with Mockingjay Part 2. The spoilers for people if you want to read the book or see the movie uninterrupted. I will tap my head when I'm done with the spoilers. All right. The deal with that is that the ending's horrible. It's awful. It's so bad. And it made me very upset and angry when I read the book. But the deal is that it didn't get so bad until, like, the last 50 pages. So I know that the whole movie's gonna be great up until the freaking ending, and I'm just gonna just get the same amount of upset and angry as I was before. So that's the whole deal. Like, the movies are going to be great, and everything leading up to the ending is fantastic, but I'm going to see it and be like, dang it, they did it again, and I'm going to be upset and angry. Done with spoilers.
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay, I was, like, turning you down and up, like, really fast.
I mean, you've heard me say it before, so
yeah, I heard most of what you said wasn't even spoilery, so...
No, it's just... anyways. Let's talk about Destiny stuff last.
Yeah, I was saying, let's talk about these updates here for Steam.
Oh, for KOTOR?
It's not specifically for KOTOR, but people were like, oh, hey, this is happening. KOTOR is actually getting touched on Steam.
Let's see.
But Steam pushed out a bunch of controller support updates for a bunch of older games, and KOTOR 2 was one of them, I believe.
Well, actually, that's not what this is about.
I thought that's what was going on, because I heard a few other games was also...
Oh. Well, maybe that's what happened, but that's not what this is about. KOTOR 2 got freaking Mac support on Steam.
It had Mac support.
It got, KOTOR 2 goes on sale on Steam and Apple's Mac App Store for $10. Is what you can look forward to. Let's see. Well, this is the whole paragraph. Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, the Sith Lords, I didn't know it was freaking called that, is coming to Mac, Linux, and Steam OS alongside a substantial PC update today, more than 10 years after its original launch date. So it apparently was not... Or maybe it's just coming to all of those platforms with the update.
Yeah.
But looks like it's coming to Mac,
because
Linux,
my sister
and Steam
owns
OS
both on
time.
Her Mac. That's, I don't know.
I
guess.
Maybe it was just the first one.
Actually, she has Windows 7 on her Mac, so.
Well, maybe. Yeah. But KOTOR 2 brings support for up to 5K resolution as well as widescreen support and achievements.
Well, then.
It's apparently like a big update. So, yeah. It's interesting that. I don't know. It's very weird that they're just like, we're going to do this to KOTOR 2 real quick.
Speaking of 5K, I found a way that with NVIDIA. Stuff with NVIDIA graphics card, you can like unlock your resolution, so I can go on freaking like Minecraft or Dishonored or even KOTOR.
Yeah,
and
I can at a certain
level. It will allow me to bump up the resolution instead of just going in to 1980. I can go all the way up to 4K if I wanted to.
Well, your TV won't show it, but yeah.
No, it
you don't have
it's not the same thing as actual 4K, but It will make it smaller. Everything's really small and
interesting.
More detailed, but it's a weird feature. But
I'm gonna freaking YOLO and try that. That's very interesting. But yeah cool.
But yeah.
So you know the deal with the Rise of the Tomb Raider, mate? That they've been talking about it at E3 and like forever. That like, it's an Xbox One timed exclusive. Xbox One timed. Exclusive.
Yeah.
Like, they would not mention any other platform, and finally the other day they came out on Twitter and was like, It's coming to Steam early 2016 and PS4 holiday 2016. So, like, that's pretty much it. Like, that's the only news. But it's like, that's so weird. That's so, so weird. Dumb. But so it's dumb. Weird that
but
they
I got
waited.
Xbox One, so.
It's weird that they waited like a year to say that. Like, they've been just saying timed exclusive for like a year. Mm-hmm. And everyone just like assumed. They're all like, oh, well, yeah, it's coming later. And then they came out with this announcement and everyone's like, whoa, shocker there, guys. A little late on that one. It's very odd.
Yeah.
But I mean, I don't care too much yet. I don't care too much about that, but
once you play Tomb Raider, you
I
will.
Mean, I what I've by the way, I mean, I will play the game, but before I even thought that I was gonna play the game, like forever ago when it came out, not forever ago, a couple of years, but when it came out a couple of years ago, and when I didn't have it and I wasn't gonna buy it, I watched somebody play through like the first quarter of the game. I was like, this is cool, but I don't know. I skimmed to his later playthroughs and saw like some of the fights at the end. They're really cool. So I don't know. I'm excited for it. Yeah, it's a fun ride, you know.
It's like a more very it's like very dark Uncharted, honestly. That's what it feels like. So.
Oh, I can't.
But it's still like cool, like freaking beating up people and
I cannot wait.
Going ham.
I cannot freaking wait for the Uncharted collection.
I need like, to pre-order.
You need to,
because
you gotta get into that beta, dude. You gotta get into that beta.
Dude, like, how many games do I need to pre-order, honestly? Like,
what's just freaking list it right now.
I'm
Halo 5, I'll... 1.
Here, I'm just gonna make a list down here.
So that things, you like
things that probably will be pre-ordered.
You know, I just wanna toss this out there to anybody important in the gaming industry listening. The whole deal with pre-orders and everyone's like, stop pre-ordering, you're supporting this bad movement. Like, people of our age do not look at it like that. Everyone else who has disposable income and can drop $60 easily on a game without questioning doesn't look at it like that. We legitimately use it as, like, financial management.
Right.
Yeah, I just want to toss that out there.
But yeah, that's true.
So, okay, you have
yeah,
your list.
Halo 5.
Halo 5, Guardians.
Tomb Raider.
Rise of the Tomb Raider.
Well,
do you care too much about that one? Because you could wait until
I could wait, like,
fall
after
it's
even released.
Friggin' PC.
Like, I know. I mean, I like the game. I like the series, but, I mean, it's not like
it's one of the lower on the totem poles of crazy awesome games.
Uncharted Collection.
Yes. You should
obviously
list these in
I already
priority.
Have Uncharted 4 pre-ordered. It's in my Destiny case.
That's awesome. That's awesome. You need to yeah, you should totally like list these in priority of like which ones are you gonna do first.
I, probably right
yeah.
Here.
Let's see. Uncharted 4, Fallout 4. Battlefront, Fallout 4. If you don't already have that.
Fallout 4, yeah.
I say Black Ops 3, but you don't want to do Black Ops 3. But you're going to be the only one who doesn't have it. Just tossing that out there on PS4. Because Jared's getting it. Ryan, obviously. Andrew,
I don't have. Most likely. That's like the game that like is underneath the totem pole for me. So.
Well, that's just sad because freaking zombies look so good this time. Okay, sorry. It looks so I'm so excited. That giant trailer was awesome. Oh, it's so good. But that's like my list. Those are my main ones for my list. Halo 5, Uncharted Collection,
yeah.
Fallout 4, Black Ops 3.
Have you already pre-ordered Uncharted 4? Or you're waiting for the collection, collector's edition?
Yeah, that's the deal. I'm waiting for the collector's edition for Uncharted 4, but Uncharted collector's edition I did immediately. So, super excited for that game. I was thinking about this the other day. Like, randomly throughout my day, I'll just be like, man, I cannot wait to play Uncharted 2 again at 1080p 60fps and get all those trophies. Like, randomly that thought pops into my head multiple times throughout a week.
You'll get to play a new game, you know.
Like, I don't randomly just
Uncharted 1.
Oh, yeah, that's true. But I don't randomly, like, throughout the day, I'm not randomly just like, Fallout 4 is going to be awesome. It is, but that's not what pops into my head. Legitimately, it just, like, all the time, I'm just like, man, I can't wait to play that Chapter 3 mission in Uncharted 3 again. Freaking, it's going to be awesome. And then, like, like, if I'm being honest with myself, I think that's my most anticipated game.
What I actually might buy the games that are closest to be released, or pre-order the games that are closest to release.
Yeah.
Like, what's the closest? Is it? It's either.
Well, Metal Gear Solid is real soon, but I don't think any of us are getting that other than Andrew. I mean, it was so much fun, but at the same time, it's like it doesn't hold your hand. It's a very old school type game, so it is very.
Yeah. I liked it though.
Yeah, but but with the old school nature of it, it's a big time investment.
I still have Witcher 3 to play.
Yeah, I know, right? I jumped into that the other day I've considered it. I didn't actually jump into it, but I was like, "Frick, I need to do this." But I think maybe one of my days off, I'll do it. I don't know. I still need to finish Persona. Don't even get started. Don't even get me started on my backlog. Anyways, but yeah, the freaking crap. What was I even talking about? I don't know. Big list of games this fall. Persona 5, if it comes out, but it will not most likely. But freaking Persona 5 is just an instant money. You freaking, oh my gosh, Persona 5. No Man's Sky is gonna most likely come out this year, but that's not, you know, available for pre-order or anything.
That's
not one of the big AAA ones. No. Oh man, we're so excited. Oh, there's so many good games coming out. Oh. Speaking of good games, segue.
Yep.
Destiny the Taken King.
Freaking.
I am so excited for the Taken King, dude. Like,
from what we're hearing, at least, there is so much.
Yeah, dude. Here. As I was saying, if I were to be honest with myself, like, I wish it was different, but my most anticipated games for this year are Uncharted Collection and Destiny the Taken King.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the Taken King comes up in my head randomly throughout, like, when I'm working, I'm like, man, we're all gonna be playing the Taken King. It's gonna be Rift. So I'm legitimately excited.
And freaking Suros weapons.
Yeah. So in the
Omelon.
Weekly. Yeah, in the weekly update.
Hake.
I said like Hake. You know.
Well, I mean, they confirmed it. Deej did.
Yeah. But
I'm about to look it up again.
I heard that, but then I also heard people, they were talking about it in one podcast and they were saying that Deej confirmed it to say it this way, and then they continued to say Hake, so I was like, Yola Swag. Let's see here. So in the weekly update, they announced weapon foundries, which is basically like in Borderlands where there are companies for your weapons like Jacobs and whatnot.
Right.
So here, I'll go over to the screen over here. Haka over here, or Hake, as if you're me, and don't give a flying fart. they gave like a design pillars by the lead artist, and then the tactical analysis by the sandbox designer for each one. We're not gonna go over those, but we can like skim them, but we're not gonna like read each paragraph. But Haka basically is like a standard form factor, like it's built for function. Stuff like that. So look at this. This auto rifle looks really cool. It's concept art for this auto rifle, and then here it is in the game.
It's Haka. Yeah.
All right. Well, I still don't give a flying fart. It's still probably gonna say okay, but I feel like it's one of those things where with a certain pronunciation, I'm just gonna go between the two.
I mean, YOLO. The correct pronunciation of Gjallarhorn is Gjallarhorn.
Yeah, no. Not on my watch, boys. But yeah, here's this shotgun in the concept art, and then here it is. Like, as you can see from the guns, they're like I said, they're function, not
flare.
Function, not flare. And I think it's a really
grade,
cool
really.
Idea.
I think it looks cool, so.
Yeah, they all look really good. Here's the pulse rifle. I like how the pulse rifle looks a lot different from the auto rifle. Like
I wonder if they're going to have a more like bullet type of sound too.
Yeah, I feel like it's going to be more of like a 21st century bullet like thud type sound, you know?
Cat just farted over here.
Was it like
he's
a
like
sound?
Laying on his... I want to see if I can show this. He's like sprawled out on my bed there, and I can smell his fart.
Oh dang it! I couldn't go to the big screen. Go back real quick.
Okay.
Here, like, big screen.
He's just sprawled out, and his butt is right there, and there's smoke of death right here.
That's amazing. So can you like hear him when he farts?
No, you just smell it.
Oh my gosh, that's messed
up. Cat fart. Gosh.
That's messed up. Yeah. All right. Moving on from Haka to Omelon.
Yeah, Haka and then Omelon here. Yeah. Guys who made a Hard Light.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, gosh, I'm dying. But, yeah, it's really cool. The whole design pillars for it is, like, experimental, bordering on irresponsible, powered by barely understood technology. It's very... This is, like, lasery, future-y,
yeah, future,
power,
very
sci-fi.
Experimental.
Which is really cool. I want lasers. You know, I want some lasers. Mm-hmm. I want some space guns. Which there are. You know, I just... There's not as many as you would think there would be. But here's the scout rifle. It's the Omelon has a really cool design. The sniper looks freaking
dope.
These
sights actually, there's gonna be new sights in the game where it actually like highlights enemies and stuff.
Yeah, I heard that's what it is for the scout rifle in Omelon.
Yeah,
which is really cool. Also, you see this right here. Mortal Console did a video on this today. You see this little circle on the side.
The liquid.
It's a liquid ammo display, so like it goes down when
as you shoot.
Yeah, it like
all that. It's awesome.
It goes all the way down, so like halfway, you'll see like halfway.
Like, and there's like one in the back on the hand cannon.
Oh, okay, that's cool. Here's the hand cannon. I like that hand cannon. I think that's really cool.
Yeah,
like you
cool.
see in the middle, like the little barrel in the middle, like with all the holes. That looks cool. Here it is in game. By the way, look at that freaking hunter in game with the feathers.
I think that must be the class, new class item.
It could. I mean, it's definitely a cloak. That's what that's from. But that's freaking interesting.
Yeah.
Look at this sniper rifle.
That sniper rifle is. It looks awesome.
I really think that's cool. I think that is really cool. It looks like a rail gun, you know.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And then a name that we all know and love.
Yeah.
Mostly me. Soros.
or
this is
how
my sword.
More console says Soros.
Oh
Soros.
Soros is elegance amidst brutality. I think that sums it up really, really well. Look at that freaking crap. I love the Soros design for that auto
rifle.
Red right
and
there.
White. Awesome.
Oh, that scout rifle actually looks really cool. I hadn't looked at that more closely than you.
There's also a pulse rifle.
Yeah, there's a pulse rifle that there's apparently like, you know, a certain, well, I don't know about one for each weapon class, but there's like there's others that aren't shown.
That rocket launcher, man.
Yeah, it looks
the holographic sight.
Really, really cool.
Freaking just pops up.
But oh gosh. Let's see here. I didn't read the. I didn't go over the tactical analysis for some of these. Yeah, Omelon is supposed to be sporting lighter ergonomic frames. It's supposed to be like Hard Light, where things fire fast. There's like the ricochet effect, stuff like that. Soros is supposed to be really, really customizable. As you guys, if you have a Soros regime, you most likely know there is the Soros regime has a decent amount of customizability, like you can switch out range and like fastness and stuff. So the Soros is all about being able to customize, which is awesome. Also, another thing in this weekly update, other than the Weapon Foundries, they kicked off the creation submitting.
I looked through some of those. It's really awesome.
It's awesome that you can just go to community and hit creations, and you can like see everyone's. Let's. You know what? Let's show off some right here. Let's go to... Oh, my goodness. Look at this Titan bubble gif right
Look
here.
Look for
awesome.
The rose, dude.
That's awesome.
Seen the rose one? It's called His Rose.
There's one that's just called Deej Agent of the Nine. And it's just Zer with Deej's face under the hood. Gosh dang it. All right. I'm going to go to highest rated. DJ Gen of the Nine is the highest rated. Oh man.
Gosh.
Key for a higher purpose, and it's Galahorn like locked in a
I saw
glass
that.
Case.
That was pretty...
That's really cool. Yeah, these are all really awesome. I'm excited to see like the winners they pick out of this, you know?
Yeah.
Really freaking something. Some of these are like super legit, and then some of these are like freaking you know, just kind of spoofs.
The Galahawk fake breaker.
I didn't see that one.
It's like a mix of all these exotics and then Fatebringer too.
That's awesome.
What was it? Looking like I think it must be in highest rated or trending, but there's one called His Rose.
What does it look like? I'm gonna scroll real quick through it.
It's about Thorn before it turned into.
That's awesome.
And it's really cool. Like I sent you this, and you can open it, but you would probably want to open it in a new tab so you can like zoom in on it and read it. But yeah, apparently the Thorn in the lore before it was called Thorn. Yeah, it was called Rose or His Rose, and I'm pretty sure Dredgen Yor was the one who owned it. And the idea of this exotic is that it's similar to the Thorn, but instead of it like having like a hand cannon type of thing, it would like charge up like a pulse rifle and have high impact. And every time you, the more charge you used, it would have a bigger like petal or shards or a thorn. And if you just shot it normally, it would be like salt, apparently. It's a weird concept, but it's kind of cool. And you would like obtain it by infusing a thorn with enough space magic salts.
Space magic salts. That's really cool, yeah. I like that it ties in with the lore.
Yeah.
Instead of just like a... Like, I saw one that was like, my fusion rifle concept. And I was like, all right.
Oh, yes.
All right, well... there's a picture of Luke Smith with Oryx as a hat.
Yeah.
That's awesome. All right. So yeah, that's let's see. Also, another thing that happened this week when it comes to Destiny was they announced what was weird is that GameStop posted a picture of the Suros Arsenal pack pre-order bonus, and everyone was like freaking out because it was like, oh, is this a pre-order bonus only for GameStop? Can you get it through the game? Blah blah. And they basically your question is interesting. We'll get to that in a minute.
Yeah.
Basically. Bungie came out and said, we don't want any rumors starting. We want to clear some stuff up. Everyone who pre-orders the Daken King will get, I believe, the Haka pack and the Suros pack and as a pre-order bonus. And for people who do not get that, and it doesn't matter where you pre-order, you get those. And if you don't do that, they can be attained through gameplay starting on January 1st.
Yeah, and my question...
I think
question,
this is dumb. That's all I gotta say.
I think it's a little silly, but, I mean... My question is... I saw a dang shader and an emblem, and I really would like to obtain these. How? Please, how?
Eric, I thought about this actually just in the last second. I mean, you'll get them. They were part of the Suros Arsenal pack. So, you get the Suros Arsenal pack.
See, then why doesn't it show the emblem in the pack, though? But it showed it on the GameStop ad. I'm probably just going to pre-order it from GameStop anyway, just to be safe. I don't care.
I bet you that you'll be fine. I bet that no matter where you get that stuff.
And before, I don't ever get that.
Except for that it can be attained through gameplay. Starting January 1st.
How would that emblem... Maybe it's a special emblem, like the Nepal thing. You know, we never know.
Yeah, but I mean, it says Suros... I mean, they're saying that the Suros Arsenal pack is attained through pre-ordering from anywhere. I mean, they wouldn't speak about the emblem, I bet. Like, that would be my guess. I mean, you can...
So
if
I go on my PS4 just go email and be like, hey, I'm going to... Spend $40.
You should get the Suros Arsenal pack, you know? That's the whole dealio. But yeah, there's that. There's the Destiny news of the week. Weapon foundries are coming. Oh, also, one thing we skipped over real quick. class-specific weapons are also happening in the Taken King. So gee freaking gee, that means a lot for the game.
And also exotic, what is it? Sparrows and exotic class items.
Well, those have been announced for a while.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, I think some of them will have, like, bonuses, too.
Yep.
And also, another thing, you know how they're moving the ghost
to the
selection
into
the front page? I'm thinking maybe we're going to get, like, ghosts with different bonuses, too, maybe.
Maybe. Maybe that's what it is, bonuses.
Because, I mean, they didn't really need to move it.
I don't know,
unless,
man.
Unless there's a specific reason to, which would be bonuses.
I don't know, man. All I know is that, like, I don't know. There's a lot going on with the Taken King, and I'm so excited to see it all. All right. You guys have... Gosh dang it. So Eric put his list of things that will probably be pre-ordered on the Google Doc, and then he put and Blops 3, and I changed it to Blops 3 in all caps, and then he just wrote it sucks, and we're leaving it as Blops 3 wow. Anyways, just to explain that silent little exchange we had there. Moving on. The drop. Let's get out of here this week. All right. Oh, I have something random to
show.
Still
no previews.
I have something to show random this week. I got it. All right. I got it on freaking lockdown.
Got it.
Because it's awesome. All right. Yeah. I want to address real quick.
New Vita.
Right. No. My fifth Vita. No. they're getting all their sales from me. Basically. Ryan Clements actually addressed this in the comments. Ryan Clements Powerhouse. PlayStation Powerhouse, to be specific. Somebody talked about it in the comments, and he was like, this is not necessarily a permanent change for the drop. Occasionally, due to travel or scheduling conflicts, I use a simplified version. My idea would still be to provide you with as much information as I can. So that's what I figured last week, but it's here again this week. Ryan Clements, stop being so busy. You're a busy man. Just slow down. Just slow down. All right? Slow down. All right. There's not too many big standouts on here, but there's some stuff that's interesting. Abyss Odyssey Extended Dream Edition for the PS4. Don't know what that is because there's no preview stuff.
Yeah. All right. And next is BlazBlue Rano Phantasma Extend.
That's
Extend.
A cool name.
Not even like Extended Edition, or just the Extend.
Maybe they're extending
Chrono
Phantasmas.
Phantasma Extend.
Maybe they have Chrono Phantasmas and they're just extending them.
Maybe. But yeah. We have no idea what that is, but it's on the PS Vita and
it's probably
some little game.
Probably some weird Japanese game. Deadpool for PS3. That game came out a while ago, I thought.
Yeah, it did.
I heard good things about it.
I've seen some of it. It's a lot of humor.
Yeah, it's just like breaking the fourth wall and just like combos, just fighting.
It's about pretty sure it's like Deadpool. There's a lot of cutscenes about him, talking about the game, making the game awesome, and stuff like that. So.
That's really cool. But I don't know. I wonder what happened there. Maybe it was just a PC 360 game and now it's on PS3.
I don't know.
King's Quest Chapter 1, A Night to Remember. PS4, PS3. Oh, it was your turn. Whoops, oh well. YOLO swag.
Okay. I'll do the next two then.
Alright, go for it.
Legend of K Anniversary, PS4, PS3, digital and retail.
Oh.
Don't have no idea what this is, but apparently it's big enough to be out in retail.
Yeah, I guess. Well, it's an anniversary, so it's gotta be like some sort of package of something.
Yeah. All right. And then, this game, Life is Strange, Episode 4. I have heard so much about this game.
Yeah, this is the one that's interesting on here. It's basically like a Telltale style game when it comes to like episodic.
I watched like 30 or an hour long playthrough of it, and it's like the choices make a lot more impact. It's definitely, if you're one of those people who are very upset when Telltale's like, oh, you choose this, but the same thing still happens. I don't really care. I still love Telltale games because they're awesome. But
I mean, sure.
Life is Strange. Each choice you make, like, directly impacts the next, like, 5 minutes. And the whole scene could change in front of you in around seconds. But it's pretty much you're this teenage girl who can travel back in time and rewind. Yeah. And
I'm interested in that. Maybe when all the episodes are out, I'll
try it's a cool idea, but like I watched some of it and it's very, very campy and I'm very hipster.
Big fan of not hipster.
Feels very campy and hipster. Like you're
big fan of
the girl you're in, the girl you're playing as is a freaking like very insecure in a photo class. It's the typical.
That's a little odd, but
like
that's funny.
But okay.
I don't know. I'm a big fan of campy stuff. I like sitcoms. I'm down with that. Lost Dimension for PS4, PS3, Vita. Or wait, no, PS3 and Vita, digital and retail.
Yeah.
And then this next game was part of like, you know how March, I don't know if it was March, one of the months had like Spring Fever. Where they had, like, a game each week. They did that for, like, a month, and one of them is this one right here.
Ah. So that's cool.
For, like, the month of July, I think.
N++.
N++ for PS4. I don't fully know what it is, but it was there as, like, being promoted, so that's all I know.
Well, next we got The Swindle for PS4, PS3, and PS Vita on digital. Three-way crossbuy, which is...
I love three-ways, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry, that's bad
No idea what the swindle is, but you're probably swindling.
You're swindling all the things.
Yeah. Swindling all right. And then, of course, Sword Art Online
Hollow Fragment.
Regarding Hollow Fragment.
PS4, digital.
Discord.
One of the best-selling Vita titles that was pretty much a PSP game on the Vita with a couple of additions. Now on the PS4, so congratulations, people.
Yeah.
You got a PSP game on the PS4. Sorry. Apparently, I looked into that game. The localization is, like, really bad. It's, like, set up as an MMO, but it's a single-player game. It's very weird. I don't know.
Weird.
I haven't played it, though, so I'm not going to judge it. I'm not going to judge it. And then last, but maybe
if there's any tentacles in it, it's
I mean, there. Of course there will be. There has to be.
Apparently there was more tentacles in Season 2
when
we stopped watching.
Gosh. I might, like, pick it up just to see how awful it got.
Yeah.
Just to freaking... Last, but maybe not least, Velocibox for the PS4 and the Vita. It could be great. It could be awful. I don't know.
Yeah, we have no idea.
Oh, there's a demo for Just Dance 2016.
Yeah, I was about to say that. Just Dance, man.
Abyss Odyssey Extended Dream Edition has a demo. Dungeon Travelers 2, The Royal Library, and The Monster Seal for Vita has a demo. That's a long name
for a
freaking game. Dungeon Travelers 2, The Royal Library, and The Monster Seal. Extended Edition. Game of the Year. No. Okay.
And of course, coming to PlayStation Music, 3 songs that no one cares about.
Yeah, I don't freaking know what's up with that. I don't know.
Coming to PlayStation Video, 3... Wait, Smosh the Movie.
Smosh the Movie. YOLO Swag.
Unfriended, which is that terrible... Like, seriously, the whole movie... I haven't seen it, but, like, it shows you the whole movie in the trailer.
Yeah. That happens a lot nowadays, sadly. Happens a lot from what I've heard.
But yeah, basically just turn off the computer. Like, done.
Alright, well, that is it for the week. I am going to go grab my random thing out of the closet.
I'll show my random thing.
I was going to say Eric can probably show you his cat while I'm gone.
Well, I was just going to show this guy right here.
Oh, snap! His Xbox One box!
It's funny. It's a funny story behind it because my mom didn't really know I was buying this, so I kind of, like, brought it inside, wrapped up in a blanket.
I'm back.
And then, yeah. Did you not hear me?
No, I said BRB and I ran to get my thing from
the
closet.
Oh, okay. Well, like, I was talking about how I had, when I got my Xbox One, my mom didn't really know I was getting it. So, I brought it in wrapped up in a blanket to conceal it.
Oh my gosh.
And then she came in earlier and was like, oh. Okay.
I see what you did there. Alright, Andrew, I just called you Andrew. Eric has his kitten to show you guys, and I
He's more of a cat now, he's gotten big enough.
He's getting bigger?
Yeah, he's getting a lot bigger.
Alright, but I have this Adam West Batman figure.
Can't even see it.
It is freaking amazing. Look at this crap. You can't, but you can look at it later. I'll send you, you know, I'll freaking send you a picture right now. I'll do it. I'll do it, I'm crazy! Just so that I can get your reaction. Because, alright, basically what happened was that I saw somewhere that I had like 24 hours to sign up for Loot Crate for the month to get the theme was Heroes. They were doing it for the second time. So I was like, maybe if I sign up, I'll get like a cool Batman figure. And I pretty much did. So... It's a win.
Dude,
me. But I sent you the picture on Facebook.
But it now that you took it out of the thing, it's devalued.
You see the little thing that says Kapow? Apparently you can peel that off and then it's a whiteboard and you can write stuff there. It's like a little caption.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's Adam West on the freaking gargoyle. It's pretty dope. I like it. But see, the thing is that I'm selective with my figures and statues and whatnot. Like and posters. As you see, I have 3 framed posters and then 2 figures over there. So I don't know if I like this guy enough. Like, I'm not a fan of the freaking Adam West show to be over with my others. So I put him in my closet, but on the top of my closet. So he's overlooking. So every time I enter my closet, Batman's like overlooking the city of my closet. So I really like him. But like, I mean, he'll still stay out. I think he's cool. But like, do you know these things, these Funko Pop things, Eric?
Yeah.
I am very close to falling down the freaking rabbit hole with Funko Pops.
Why?
Because they're so awesome. And the thing is, they're really cool, and they're only like $10
each.
You mean
like the one like you have of Rick?
Yeah, Rick over there. But see, Funko Pops are everything. They're like Rick, the style with the big head and the eyes. It's those, but with like everything. Like I could get Arrow from the show and just put him over there with Rick. And they're like the same size, and they're hanging out, and it's like $10.
Right.
It's so easy to fall down that rabbit hole, but I won't. I'm going to stay strong.
Like Amiibos with less value.
Yeah. And freaking less money. Like, it costs less. And they're cooler. For me, at least.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'm tempted to get a Batman to put over there with Rick. But, Adam West here. And that is it for the week for our show, Gamer Gen Duo Podcast. You can leave us some feedback on Twitter. I am at TBStack. Eric is at LegendPVM. Finally. Mm-hmm. Because that took so long for him to change. Not really. But
actually, it took really
2 seconds, Kappa. But, yeah, so reach out to us on Twitter. Let us know how you're liking the podcast. If you're listening on iTunes, if you're watching on YouTube, leave a comment, rate us. Tell us how your day's going. Because I'm interested. How's your day going? Because I love you, and I miss you.
Mr. Sprinkles is online.
Mr. Sprinkles is online. Goodbye, everybody.